I swear I'm gonna be like this throughout the entire video. It's just so hot. It is once again hot as hell today in my room, and I picked the hottest day this week of San Diego to film this video, but I already did my hair, I already did my makeup, and I have my little fan over here, so I'm hoping we'll survive better this time compared to last time. What's going on, guys? It's Daniela, and welcome back to my channel. I have noticed that I've been kind of mumbling over my words, so I'm gonna kind of try
to talk a little bit slower and really get all my
words out without rushing. I don't know why I'm always in a rush, but your girl is, I guess. As you read by the title, today I'm gonna be doing another haul, and I'm actually really excited for this one because it's one that I actually originally wanted to do first before the Shein. And now that I have more stuff together and I just feel more prepared, I feel really excited for it. And also, this one has like a little place in my heart because if you follow me on social media, I'm always posting that I'm working out, that I'm active, that I'm going hiking, just always on my feet, and I'm always pretty much wearing workout clothes. The majority of clothes I wear on a day-to-day basis is pretty much just workout clothes, and even if I'm going out, I'm usually always wearing like my leggings that are my workout leggings. But yeah, so I'm really excited to show you guys all these things today. So quick little story time before I actually get into the haul. Ever since I was young, I was never the type of person who could afford very expensive high-end clothes, makeup, hair products, whatever it is. It was always just what we could afford. Or when I started making money, I would spoil myself and start getting my workout clothes at like TJ Maxx, at Marshall's, Ross. And I will talk a little bit into those stores and what I think about their workout clothes too, just because these things that I did get today are a little bit on the pricier end. I will explain why it's worth it, but I totally understand the people who cannot afford this because I wasn't able to afford this like 3 years ago. And I will say before I start as well, TJ Maxx, Marshall's, Ross workout clothes, you can find some really good stuff in those stores. It just kind of depends on the material that you like, and some things are not squat proof, which is something that I always look for in workout leggings. But for the majority of stuff that I did get at those stores, they did do me well, and I was perfectly fine using them before I started over here. So you guys are totally okay getting those things. So here are my Gymshark workout clothes. Now, I definitely wanted to get kind of a range of things that were outside my comfort zone, things that I kind of thought that I would definitely like, and just see what I could kind of find on my size that was available, because they don't go past an XL. So I wanted to see exactly what they had just in that size. So talking about sizing, everything that I got in this bunch is an XL. I did not size down in anything. I got the biggest size that I could just because I really wasn't sure how Gymshark was gonna be. They don't really have like a plus size line, and not only that, but some brands XLs are not XLs, and I just wanted to ensure that at least something would fit me. Now, I will be keeping all my Gymshark because I did try everything on and I did work out with it because I wanted to get an accurate review. I didn't just want to have them on and then just go work out and then I ended up not liking them. I want to start off with a two-piece, which I normally would never get two pieces. Two pieces are just not really my thing. Same with like these bright colors. I usually wouldn't go for colors just because I really feel like they accentuate the features that I wouldn't want to be accentuated. But as I'm trying to get more comfortable with my body and after trying these outfits on, I surprisingly felt really, really confident, not gonna lie. So to start off with the bra, I really, really, really like the back design. I really like how thick this band is and how it says Gymshark. I was kind of hesitant on the thickness of this strap because I do have a little bit of back fat right here, and usually I like really thick straps. Now, this isn't the thinnest, of course, but I was a little worried, and luckily enough, with the pants and together, everything was fine and I looked really good. I just really, really liked how I looked. These are the type of bras that have like the padding that could come out and in. It wasn't too bad with putting it in the washer. Luckily, they didn't come out, but I do feel like eventually they will. The straps are adjustable, and I will say that this is probably like a low impact type of bra. And if you don't know what that means, a low impact type of bra is like maybe when you're only doing weights, not really cardio, because your boobs will be bouncing around. Definitely one of those bras that's like cute for Instagram and for a cute pic, but I definitely wouldn't wear this to go run a mile just because it doesn't have much support. Now, going along with the matching pants, you see, I love these because of the color. I think the detail that they have with their pants and how it says Gymshark, I think it's so cute. The band is very thick. I don't know if you can tell in the picture, I mean in the video, but it's very thick and I really felt it hug me on my waist. Now they definitely fit me comfortable, but I would probably size down when it comes to this design. It does have this like little design in the bottom, which is supposed to make your butt look bigger, but I didn't really notice a difference when it came to this. If I had an ass, I would probably notice a difference. They definitely were squat proof, but what I did have an issue on is that on the side right here, when I was wearing like my dark underwear, because I was wearing I think like black underwear with these, I could see kind of like the line of my underwear over here, and it's not that big of a deal, but I do think it's like a detail that should be said. The one issue that I noticed that I constantly had with their pants is that they were super long. They're extremely long, and when I did want to kind of roll them up a little bit, the design is so different on the inside that it was pretty obvious that I rolled it up and it just didn't really look that nice. And on one of the sides of the ankles, there's like the tags, and it was really hard to kind of cover that up with me rolling it. Like I really had to do a thick roll on my ankle and I did not like that. But overall, I think they're cute. They're definitely one of those outfits that I would wear for like a good picture or to just kind of feel good, look good. It was a cute little moment. So the next thing that I want to go with is this sports bra that I got. This is a blue or teal sports bra that I got. The front is very different. It's not really so like a sports bra where it's like covering up here. It's definitely kind of like a bikini kind of top, and I was just a little bit worried on how I would like that on my body. Now surprisingly, I actually absolutely loved this bra. It was actually probably one of my favorite things that I purchased from Gymshark, and I definitely feel like I'd rebuy this for sure out of everything that I got. The bra padding is adjustable, not adjustable, but it does come in and out as well, and I really like that it didn't just go to like my boob area. So I had a good amount of coverage, and I will say this is kind of like medium impact. The only thing that I did have a problem with was when I was doing jumping jacks and stuff, since the design is kind of like a bikini top and I do have big boobs, my boobs were kind of like slipping out. But other than that, if I just like kind of tucked them back in, everything was perfectly fine. So this was definitely a steal and I really, really liked it. The material is really good. That is one thing that I noticed about Gymshark that I was kind of pleasantly surprised about. For the price that they charge you for, they do give you pretty good material. It's heavy and it seems like it's gonna last a good amount of time. All right, going on to my third thing. So I wanted to make sure that I got some black leggings from them because my all-time favorite leggings are from Fabletics. They're solid black. I'm currently wearing them and I wear them all the time. No other legging has ever compared to Fabletics, and I will explain that when I get to Fabletics. Because so this was a pretty big competition that they were going against. Will I say Gymshark is my new black leggings favorite? No. No. This is also kind of the same design that the pink ones had. So you can't really tell, you can barely tell, but they had like that butt thing right here where they could like help you make your ass look better. And they did have the Gymshark logo up here. Same fitting as the pink ones as well. I do think that these black ones though fit me better for some reason. I did kind of have to like move a little bit around to kind of adjust them. But once they were on, super comfortable. I did notice a little bit that after my workout, they did fit a little bit loose, so I could have probably sized down as well with all these leggings. And same issue as the other one, when I wanted to roll it up, the tags are right here, and once again I had to do like a really thick roll on my ankle, and that's one thing that was very unfortunate. So my final thing that I got from Gymshark was one more pair of leggings, and it was something that was very outside my comfort zone because I don't normally try to go for like super cute trendy styles when it comes to leggings, just because I just want to get my shit done at the gym. These were definitely on the fashion kind of sense of leggings. As you guys can see, it's kind of like asymmetrical. There's a lot of like designs here. We have the pocket, and then if you look all the way down here, the ankle is kind of like diagonal, so it's kind of giving you a little bit of a lot of symmetry. And I definitely would say it was surprisingly a good fitting. It actually fit very nicely, but the same thing that I have with normal bright colored leggings, I do feel like they kind of make my tummy look way more spontaneous than usual, and I don't really like that. Although my sister, she was kind of telling me that they looked really good. She really liked how they looked on me. She didn't feel like they made me look bigger. The material is very different compared to these two leggings that I got. It's very thin. It kind of feels like yoga pants, not so thick, high impact leggings. And I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of that, just because I really like to have support, especially around my tummy area. And I did have to keep lifting these up, which was a little bit annoying. But if you're looking for kind of like a cute design and just for comfortability, this is definitely one for you. So that kind of completes my Gymshark side of this video. Now let's get started on my favorite, which is Fabletics. I have a lot when it comes to Fabletics, and I'm even missing a few things that I already have in my closet from Fabletics, which I'll probably just talk about. Now, I did want to take a little moment and talk about the entire Fabletics website and how it kind of works, because it is a little bit confusing when you just go straight onto the website trying to get some leggings or some shirts, whatever the case is. Now, the membership, I believe, is like $50 a month, and you can pick one outfit a month for them to send to you. Personally, I think that is definitely a good deal. It makes kind of the top and the bottom to be 25 and 25, which is pretty good because their original prices are very pricey, and I will explain that as well once I kind of start showing you guys the clothes. It is kind of a hit or miss every month, just because you don't know exactly what new outfits are gonna be, but you can always like skip a month and not pay and then just wait till next month to see what they have. This is not sponsored, by the way. I just really like to clarify this because when I first got the membership, it was so confusing, and I was just not really aware of all these things before I got it. To start off, I'm gonna do my little blue set that is brand new. So these were the shorts. I got them in an extra large. I have gotten two pairs of shorts from them before, and they're very good quality. I absolutely love their shorts. They're thick, even this one. It's thick, it's good material. I know it's gonna last me a while. If you know how to wash clothes well, it's gonna definitely last a couple months, even probably more than that. All the clothes that I've had is over a year old, and it still looks really, really good. I just don't want to be so specific on how long it's gonna last you, because I don't want y'all coming at me. These shorts alone, I have the tag right here, are $65. And I know you guys are already, your jaw, pick up your jaw. I know it dropped. But with the outfit deals that are monthly, these shorts with this top was, I believe, $45, or it was like 50. Some are like maybe like a $5 difference. This top alone is $45, so you kind of get a steal when you kind of add these two things as original prices compared to the outfit deal that you can get through the membership. The one thing that I will say about this top is that it's not my favorite. As I mentioned in my last video on my Shein haul, I have this thing when it comes to plus size crop tops. I definitely got this oversized. I got this in a 2x, I think, or a 3x, and it's of course big, but it's not how I wanted it to fit. It is a very thick shirt, very good material. Like I said, their material is something that I just absolutely love. I've never been fully disappointed on any of their products, maybe like one or two. So this outfit was definitely very, very cute. I will probably be wearing these shorts more than the top. I'll probably end up giving this away because it's not really my style, and I really didn't like the fitting. I felt like it kind of made me look a lot bigger since it's like a really thick shirt. But for the price and the outfit, it is very cute. So this is the second outfit. It came with these black leggings, which I absolutely love, as I've mentioned a billion times, and it came with this top. So this is the front. It has a little tie in the front, and then in the back, it has a kind of band design, I guess I can say. As you guys know, I am obsessed with what? Black leggings from Fabletics. This is like literally a brand new pair, which I'm really excited to show you guys. This is kind of the regular sized leggings. Something I absolutely love about Fabletics is that you're able to decide on the length of your leggings, and I adore that about them because, one, they're all inclusive with sizing, and they're also all inclusive on their height difference. My sister, who I live with, she's shorter than me. She's able to decide finally on some good pair of leggings that can fit her correctly. You know, most of the times they don't fit her that well. She was actually the first one who introduced me to Gymshark, and she had gave me her leggings because they just fit her way too long. I feel like this video is me just like bashing Gymshark and talking talking so good about Fabletics, but I swear it wasn't meant to happen that way. I really thought Gymshark was gonna impress me a little bit more. They really go high on high-waisted. I'm actually wearing my favorite pair right now, which is these, but my old ones. And the color has not faded much of a difference, to be honest, compared to some brand new ones and the old ones that I have. And before I actually push these to the side, the price of these alone are $70. These by themselves are just $70. Once again, pick up your jaw because I'm sure it dropped. But with the top combined, this was a $50 deal, I believe, $45, $50 deal. And that is with the membership. So I'm telling you, you do get a pretty good deal when it comes to their outfits, just depending on which ones you get. Now, as much as I keep talking great about it, I will say that this top wasn't so much in that case. There are a few things, of course, with every single brand and every single collection that's kind of hit or miss, and this was kind of not one of my favorites, but I will say it's a cute top. Like, it definitely fit very nicely on. I like the idea of having this kind of like cinched up, and the design in the back is kind of hidden, so it does kind of look like just a blue top. It's not so much of a top to wear as a sports bra. I don't even think that's what it was designed for. I'm sure this is like specifically a top. And yeah, the material is okay. It's not too bad, but for $45 on its own, I definitely wouldn't purchase this by itself. With the outfit, it was kind of a good deal because at least I got to see what it was like, you know? So leaving off on some long leggings moment, I did want to proceed with some biker shorts. So these are kind of going into the things that I already have in my closet from Fabletics from a while back. These were very cute when they arrived, and they don't look much different from when I first got them. This is after washing them plenty of times. Like I said, these clothes I wear all the time. These are the clothes that are my go-to. So pretty much every day, I'm not even kidding, almost every single day I wear at least one of these things, and I wash them obviously every single week. So the fact that they're not fading, they're still intact with their material, is great. The one issue that I did have with these was that I wasn't too much of a fan as how it looked around my tummy area, but that's just my preference. It's really not so much on this, it's more on me mentally. But other than that, they were very cute, and I feel like I just need to stop being a little bitch and just kind of love myself because they are very cute. So now going on into some sports bras. Now I'm gonna show you guys three sports bras that I've already had, and they're kind of in between high impact and medium impact. None of these are low impact. I'm gonna be showing you guys the white one. I believe when I got the biker shorts, they came with this bra. So this was like a set of its own. The sports bra is actually one of my favorites that I have. It's just because of the design and how it's so complimenting to my body. It is pretty similar when it came to the Gymshark one, with kind of having like a bikini top, except this one is just completely like tied together. And the Gymshark one, I'll show it to you guys right here, it's very open, if that makes sense. I hope I'm making sense with explaining that. I really like the back of this sports bra. It does have a little compartment right here where you could insert your phone, but my phone does not fit. So if you have anything bigger than an 8 plus, which I think that's the biggest iPhone, right? No, it's like the XR, right? It will not fit here. And this little design right here, I think, is so cute. It's really simple yet really flattering, and it really holds you in. This is definitely one of those bras that I wear when I do cardio, when I know I'm going to be jumping around. Going on with this sports bra, this sports bra is definitely a very high impact sports bra, and when I know I'm going to be just running, this is the one I go to. Of course, there is some wear into this bra because I wear this stuff all the time and it's not brand new. The design in the back looks like this. It like crosses over. It's so hard to like lift this up, but it crosses over and it has like this little feature right here, and it's super cute. Like I said, with the white one, it's a very small added detail, but it does do a difference. And with this bra, you would kind of clip it in the front, and then you would tie it up in the front right here. And the amount of impact this has on your boobs is absolutely ridiculous. Like, it really holds me in. I do feel like I probably could have sized up. All these things that I got from Fabletics are XL on both ends, so XL on top and XL on the bottom. With some bras, I do feel like I probably could have sized up a little bit, but overall, like, they do fit. It does give me kind of a tight fitting sometimes on the side, depending if I'm like super bloated one morning or not. The one thing that I will say, to have kind of a different perspective on on this specific bra. My sister did have it and she really didn't like how it made her back feel. She did feel like it kind of was putting a lot of pressure on her back and a lot of restraint. As I mentioned, like, it is a very high impact and tight bra, so maybe she could have sized up as well and we wouldn't really have that issue. But overall, like, it's a pretty good sturdy bra, and right here it's really thick, as you guys can see. Like, I don't really need to pull that much so you guys can see the resistance. This bra that I'm holding up is a little bit similar with the white one, just with the fact of it having a little compartment right here for your phone. Same thing though, it does not fit my phone, so it's kind of just there for no reason, but it doesn't really make it too obvious. It really blends in perfectly, and this is a pretty solid sports bra as well as the blue one. It's very thick in the material. I don't think the bra things are adjustable. Oh, they are. I didn't even notice this. You see, with this bra and this one, the bra compartment never really came out because they're so far away. Like, this is where the bra is, this is where the little compartment is at. So I've never had an issue with them coming out. The material is soft, it is very sturdy, it's thick. I don't know, I feel like I keep saying the same things over and over again for these products, but it's just because they're very similar, which is a very good thing, I feel like, for a brand. They're very consistent with having the materials be kind of the same quality, and it really just doesn't disappoint. I have two more things left, and then that kind of completes the Fabletics haul. So this was one of the pants that I got from, like, the Kelly Rowland collection. I really fell in love with this color when it was in the pictures, and when it arrived, I absolutely was obsessed with these. The material of it is really fucking good. I don't know how many times I need to say this, but Fabletics, that's one thing that I'm going to keep mentioning and mentioning and mentioning and mentioning. The material is just amazing. I absolutely love it. It's lasted me so long. The only reason why I say these aren't my favorite is same thing as the biker shorts. It's just me being picky on my own body and just saying that I don't like the fitting on my personal self, but they have nothing to do with the actual pants. These were some gray leggings that I wasn't such a big fan of how they fit, and these are actually because of the leggings themselves. Now, the other ones are me just being picky on myself. These are specifically on the pants. My sister also has a pair of these, and she also felt like they just did not make her butt look good. So the back of it, as you guys can see, it's kind of like just, I guess, normal leggings. But the style of how it is on your butt definitely does not complement it well at all. Maybe if I would have sized up, it would have fit me how I expected it to. The color of it is, like, really nice. I really like the style down here. It kind of has this, like, design where when you wear it, it has, like, these little holes and you could, like, see your skin through it. The band right here is very thick. But the one thing that, like I said, I really didn't like was how it made my butt look. I really didn't like how it looked. Like I've mentioned, I don't have a big butt in general, so this definitely accentuated me not having one, and I wouldn't repurchase these. Okay, so that pretty much completes this haul. We finally got all these clothes all reviewed, and I hope I kind of gave you guys a good brief description on, let me fix my camera real quick. I hope I gave you guys a good description and kind of explained everything thoroughly. If you guys do have any questions when it comes to any of these products, definitely comment that down below. I really will take the time to reply to you guys and anything you guys have. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. If you are new, turn on your post notifications, and I'll see you next time. Mwah.